So, hello guys, we are here in our Ford Focus MK2, and yeah, since we are getting rid of this car, because it's old and like all electric gremlins in it start to show up, like the 2006-2007 model, yeah, I wanted to show you all the controls and features Ford built into this wondrous car, since I've been driving this thing for like 5 or 6 years now. Yeah, it has been almost reliable and actually never really broke down, but some parts broke down. So, and maybe you learned it in driving school or maybe not, but when you're sitting down into a new car, or if you are renting a Ford Focus from somebody, or if you try a new used old car, you may find something interesting. Or if you're driving a Focus, maybe I'm missing something, or maybe you missed something. So I'll show all the features I know. Most important, the warning lights are here, not very well hidden, which is really nice. Clima control, if you want to call it, ventilator, temperature, where the stuff goes, the AC, keep the air inside. This has a heated front glass here, front window. That's quite nice, activated by this button. Back window heater is here. ESP can be, if you have a working ESP, you can deactivate it here for what reason, whatever. Here we have the light, the 12 volt connector. Oh, the ashtray, if you have one, but it's like in every car I ever have seen, it's lost. One thing we had with our, like this thing is a little bit loose. And if it's like all downwards, sometimes you cannot move the automatic knob anymore. And another thing is, you have to always set it to P. Like if you're on N, I think you can't remove the key or something. Like this happened to me once. So that's just something nice to know. The mirrors can be set right here. Go to left side and then set up the mirror there. And right side for the right mirror. Lock the car here. Come up, unlock, open the door. Get this nice metal grip here. Can control all the windows here if the ignition is on. Just do. We can lock the kids windows in the back side via this knob, and the small light shows that the windows are locked. It's almost imperceptible. Let's go for light. Light's important. We have like an automatic mode which turns on the light when it's getting dark. Does not work so well on fog, so that's something to be aware of. And speaking of fog, which was really hard for me to figure out, is how to get fog lights on. Yeah, so like we have first to change to either driving light or normal light. It would be off. Actually, so we have to activate one of the lights, then pull it out once for the fog front light, and pull it out twice for the fog back light. Actually, if you have like an annoying error message here, you can just remove it via here. You can also, if you press it longer, we can reset like our daily kilometers. Back to auto, we can control the light level on the menu and radio and everything via here. I usually set it to very, very low, so my night sight is not influenced. If we have load on the car, we can move the, even here, the electric motors, you can move the lights a little bit up or down. Should only do this if you have something loaded, else you'll blind your incoming traffic. So the board computer can control via here. Actually, here is like the strong light, like in every car. If you pull it a little bit harder, should stay in there. Signals, same. Can yeah, give signals or that. This flipper, we can control the computer, show all the stuff. It's a really thirsty car as well. Usually can go into settings, change the language, units. Now we have sounds. Beep. Didn't know that. Why did I steal this car? Now that it can speak with me. Here we have the control for the radio. Like up and down, seeks for a new channel. Here is volume up, volume down. Your button mode, you can change the radio mode like to the CD player or aux or whatever. Quite easy, that one. The speed control does work here. When you're driving at the velocity you want to keep, you press on, then keeps the current speed off, deactivates the thing. If you had to brake, if you brake, the cruise control is disengaged, but you can go to yes and it goes back to the last speed you had been on when you activated it. Or if you want to go a little bit faster or slower, you can control this via plus and minus here. The wiper controls, here is the washing machine. If you pull it down once, it gives you like one motion. One up is like the rain sensor, which really works nice. You can control the interval here. I think up is slower, down is faster. Somewhere in the middle is usually good. Then you have like medium speed and high speed. I usually have done them on the sensor mode. Do we have everything inside the car? I think so. So let's see how. Because if the magical hood is open, because yeah, here you have like your OBD port for your sensor device, but it's nothing to open the hood. How does that work? Let's go off outside and find out. Yeah, Ford is really clever here. You have to flip this, and then you get in with your key. One for unlock and second for getting it actually open. So, I think, yeah, at least you are not hurting your fingers. So, here we have like the hydraulic steering fluid, the heating fluid, wiper washer, water. You can refill oil here, you can measure your oil level here. I think this is the most important for most people. We have the plugs, spark plugs here, battery here, air filters probably here. I've never opened it because it's screwed down. Usually it should be, in my view, this is something which should be clamped. So, but the thing on your cars, the air filters last much longer than, at least in theory. But yeah, actually this thing broke for our cars once. Also, the dead reservoir here broke, like on the lid somewhere. Split the whole engine room with hydraulic fluid. So, yeah, let's go inside and see how you can move flap the back chairs. So one thing that hadn't been so obvious for us. Yes. Another ashtray. Yeah. It's that you can actually flip up this in the seat here, and then you get like a little bit more space. You can flip around the seats via that small button there, and if you have the lower part flipped up, you get a little bit more space in the car. But this does not work if your front seat is all the way back. So for big people, it's a little bit disappointing. But yeah, a little bit more space you can get out of it. So here is our storage compartment. You have like points where you can attach like rope or something here. If you want to transport anything, you can secure it that way. The emergency wheel and jack are here, and you have like two secret storage compartments here and here
where maybe you have your emergency kit, first aid kit, and this one has another 12 volt adapter here. Yeah, and that's actually the whole car, so let me know if I missed anything or if you found anything new or interesting. It's a very basic car with no bells and whistles, at all. Just actually the hood flipping was actually the thing which we had most problems to find out overall. But yeah, was reliable mostly. Never really broke down. Yeah, just like really, really many small electric gremlins showing up in the last couple of years. So that's why it's going to the graveyard now.